This is the day that the Lord has made, that the Lord has made. I will rejoice, I will rejoice and be glad in it, and be glad in it. This is the day that the Lord has made. I will rejoice and be glad in it. This is the day, this is the day that the Lord has made. This is the day, this is the day that the Lord has made, that the Lord has made. I will rejoice and be glad in it, and be glad in it. This is the day that the Lord has made. I will rejoice and be glad in it. This is the day, this is the day that the Lord has made.
The Mass intention is for Geraldine Pinson, that's the mother of Mary Kana, requested by Jenny Harris. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit, amen. The Lord be with you. And to prepare ourselves to celebrate the sacred mysteries, let us acknowledge our sins and ask for God's mercy and forgiveness. I confess to Almighty God and to you, my brothers and sisters, that I have greatly sinned in my thoughts and in my words, in what I've done and in what I've failed to do, through my most grievous fault. Therefore, I ask Blessed Mary, a Virgin, all the angels and saints, and you, my brothers and sisters, to pray for me to the Lord our God. May the Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Lord, have mercy. Lord, have mercy. Lord, have mercy. Mercy, mercy. Christ, have mercy. Christ, have mercy. Christ, have mercy, mercy, mercy. Lord, have mercy, Lord, have mercy, Lord, have mercy, mercy, mercy.
Glory to God in the highest, and on earth peace to people of goodwill. We praise you, we bless you, we adore you, we glorify you, we give you thanks for your great glory. Lord God, Heavenly King, O God, Almighty Father, Lord Jesus Christ, Holy Begotten Son, Lord God, Lamb of God, Son of the Father, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. You take away the sins of the world, receive our prayer. You are seated at the right hand of the Father, have mercy on us. For you alone are the Holy One, you alone are the Lord, you alone are the Most High, Jesus Christ, who with the Holy Spirit, in the glory of God the Father. Amen.
Let us pray. Almighty ever-living God, who gave us the Paschal mystery in the covenant you established for reconciling the human race, so dispose our minds, we pray, that what we celebrate by professing the faith, we may express it in deeds. Grant this prayer through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God, forever and ever.
Reading from the Acts of the Apostles. After the crippled man had been cured, while Peter and John were still speaking to the people, the priests, the captain of the temple guard, and the Sadducees confronted them, disturbed by what they were teaching the people and proclaiming in Jesus the resurrection of the dead. They laid hands on Peter and John and put them in custody until the next day, since it was already evening. But many of those who heard the word came to believe, and the number of the men grew to about 5,000. On the next day, their leaders, elders, and scribes were assembled in Jerusalem with Annas the high priest, Caiaphas, John, Alexander, and all who were the high priest's class. They brought them into the presence and questioned them, "By what power or by what name have you done this?" Then Peter, filled with the Holy Spirit, answer them, "Leaders of the people and elders, if we are being examined today about a good deed done to a cripple, namely by what means he was saved, then all of you and all of the people of Israel should know that it was the name of Jesus Christ, the Nazarene, whom you crucified, whom God raised from the dead. In his name, this man stands before you healed. He is a stone rejected by you, the builders which has become the cornerstone. There is no salvation through anyone else, nor is there any other name under heaven given to the human race by which we are all to be saved." The word of the Lord.
The stone rejected by the builders has become the cornerstone. The stone rejected by the builders has become the cornerstone.
Give thanks to the Lord, for he is good, for his mercy endures forever. Let the house of Israel say, "His mercy endures forever." Let those who fear the Lord say, "His mercy endures forever."
The stone rejected by the builders has become the cornerstone.
The stone which the builders rejected has become the cornerstone. By the Lord has this been done. It is wonderful in our eyes. This is the day the Lord has made. Let us be glad and rejoice in it.
The stone rejected by the builders has become the cornerstone.
O Lord, grant salvation. O Lord, grant prosperity. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. We bless you from the house of the Lord. The Lord is God, and he has given us light.
The stone rejected by the builders has become the cornerstone.
And rejoice in it.
The Lord be with you. A reading from the Holy Gospel according to John. Jesus revealed himself again to his disciples at the Sea of Tiberias. He revealed himself in this way. Together were Simon Peter, Thomas called Didymus, Nathanael from Cana in Galilee, Zebedee's sons, and two other of his disciples. Simon Peter said to them, "I'm going fishing." They said to him, "We also will come with you." So they went out and got into the boat, but that night they caught nothing. When it was already dawn, Jesus was standing on the shore, but the disciples did not realize that it was Jesus. Jesus said to them, "Children, have you caught anything to eat?" They answered him, "No." So he said to them, "Cast the net over the right side of the boat, and you'll find something." So they cast it, and were not able to put it in because of the number of fish. So the disciple whom Jesus loved said to Peter, "It is the Lord." When Simon Peter heard that it was the Lord, he tucked in his garment, for he was lightly clad, and jumped into the sea. The other disciples came in the boat, for they were not far from shore, only about 100 yards, dragging the net with the fish. When they climbed out on shore, they saw a charcoal fire with fish on it and bread. Jesus said to them, "Bring some of the fish you just caught." So Simon Peter went over and dragged the net ashore, full of 153 large fish. Even though there were so many, the net was not torn. Jesus said to them, "Come, have breakfast." And none of the disciples dared to ask him, "Who are you?" Because they realized it was the Lord. Jesus came over and took the bread and gave it to them, and in like manner the fish. This was now the third time Jesus was revealed to his disciples after being raised from the dead. The Gospel of the Lord. The story of the crippled man continues to unveil from the time the crippled man asked for something from John or from Peter and John, when John and they didn't have the coins to give him, they gave this man his life. And yesterday we heard he really was stuck to them. He was following them wherever they were going. And today we hear that now this has become a problem for some leaders of the Jews and other people. And that's why St. Peter, filled with the Holy Spirit, when they asked him, "In what name did you do this?" And he said to them, "Are you examining us for this good done to the crippled man? But if you want to know, it has been done in the name of the Jesus Christ, whom you crucified, but he was raised from the dead." This was not good in their ears. And we see that this thing do happen even now, that when you do good, it's not always the same reaction you are going to get from people. People always want to examine even the goodness of a person. But like Peter, we should not be afraid to stand for the goodness that comes from God. And goodness always goes with the truth, because if you do not have the truth, you cannot do what is good. And that's what St. Peter is showing up here. You want to know where this good is, I'm going to tell you the truth. The truth is, it comes from not us, but in the name of our Lord Jesus Christ. So he stood for that miracle of goodness, but showing the truth of where this came from. And that is the way you and I, as disciples of Christ today, we have to stand up for the goodness, not just for ourselves, but for so many people, and to stand and defend that goodness in truth. We have seen, like I've said, so many people, even in the world today, who are being killed, imprisoned because of the goodness. just another example, maybe. We may not know much, but what is happening in Russia with a political leader who is in prison now going on hunger strike, just because he wants to stand for the truth and for the goodness of the people, is being almost persecuted. Hopefully, he'll be alive, that he may come out and continue to do what is good. But that is what happens when you do good. Not everyone receives it in a way you think. People who criticize you, people who examined you, whom does she think she is, whom does he think he is, because of that goodness. But Peter is showing us, stand up for the truth so that you keep that goodness going. And I think that's what Jesus Christ is teaching his disciples here about the goodness of his life and the way he lived with them. He followed them even when they were going away from him, so that they can come back and continue to do what is good. That's what we are seeing now in the Acts of the Apostles, because these apparitions, when Jesus was following them, he wanted to bring them back to that goodness and the truth. And in the actions that he was doing during the apparitions, he was reminding them of the goodness. Look at what he did. He provided breakfast. That is a good gesture to people, to provide something for the people. And then he gave them the bread. He reminded them of the miracle of the loaves and the fish. That one time, you remember, there were thousands of people, and you did just have little, but we spread out and we shared the goodness. We shared the bread. We shared the fish. This is what he was reminding them. Do not forget about this. Don't just think about yourselves. Because when they were going to fishing, it was about themselves. They were going back to the old way of life, in the livelihood of being fishermen, so they can sell for their lives. But he reminded them, your job is to give. And he gave them the bread. He gave them the fish. Remember the multiplication of the loaves and the fish. So that is what Christ was following them, to remind them of the goodness and the truth. And that is how he reminds us today, during this Easter season, is to do good and to do what is the truth, especially in this time, that we should not be afraid to stand up for what is good. Even our family members, sometimes we are criticized, sometimes we are even pushed away, because we are truthful and we want something good, people take it differently. But Peter and John, they are telling us, hold on to the goodness by standing up to the truth. My dear sisters and brothers, the homely image of the risen Jesus cooking breakfast for his disciples is a sign of his presence with us, offering us the hospitality of his holy table. Through him, we present our prayers and petitions. That in this Eucharist, we may feel close to the risen Christ, and through him, appreciate that we are all brothers and sisters, we pray to the Lord. That throughout the world, from the rising of the sun to his setting, the offering of thanksgiving may give glory to God, we pray to the Lord. That those who are in prison the world may unite themselves with Peter and John, who while under arrest continue to be filled with the consolation of the Holy Spirit, we pray to the Lord. That the work of people in the medical professions may be blessed as they strive to bring healing to those with COVID-19 and reassurance and comfort to all who are sick at this time, we pray to the Lord. That all who exercise various ministries at our parish receive abundant Easter blessings from God during this week of the resurrection, we pray to the Lord. Almighty God and Father of light, we give thanks to you, for your love is without end. Grant salvation to the world through Christ our Lord.
Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation, for through your goodness we have received the bread we offer you, fruit of the earth and work of man's hands. It will become for us the bread of life. Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation, for through your goodness we have received the wine we offer you, fruit of the vine and work of man's hands. It will become our spiritual drink. Pray, my dear sisters and brothers, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God the Almighty Father. Perfect within us, O Lord, we pray, the solemn exchange brought about by these Paschal offerings, that we may be drawn from earthly desires to a longing for the things of heaven through Christ our Lord. The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
Lift up the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is truly right
and just, our duty and our salvation, at all times to acclaim you, O Lord, but in this time, above all, to lord you yet more gloriously, when Christ our Passover has been sacrificed. For he is the true Lamb who has taken away the sins of the world. By dying, he has destroyed our death, and by rising, restored our life. Therefore, overcome with Paschal joy, every land, every people exults in your praise, and even the heavenly powers, with the angelic hosts, sing together and handing him of your glory, as they acclaim. You are indeed holy, O Lord, the fount of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread and, giving thanks, broke it and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it. For this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith.
When we eat this bread and drink this cup, we proclaim your death, O Lord, until you come again. When we eat this bread and drink this cup, we proclaim your death, O Lord, until you come. come, until you come, until you come again.
Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that, partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world, and bring out the fullness of charity, together with Francis, our Pope, and Robert, our Bishop, and all the clergy. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us, all we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Blessed Joseph, her spouse, with the blessed apostles and glorious martyrs, and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life, and may please and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him and with him and in him, O God, almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours, forever and ever.
Amen. 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 Amen.
At the Savior's command, and formed by divine teaching, we dare to say, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Gracious, grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ. Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, Peace I leave you, my peace I give you, look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever. Amen. The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
Now let us safely offer each other the sign of Christ's peace.
Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world. Have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world. Have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world.
Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I'm not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed.
was Lord. Take my hand, lead me on, let me stand.
The risen Christ is always ready to take our hands, like he did to the apostles. He asked them to cast, that's taking their hands and helping them. And we, as disciples of Christ today, the only way we can do good and stand for the truth is to let him lead us. So we have to let him take our hands. Let us pray. Keep safe, O Lord, we pray, those whom you have saved by your kindness, that redeemed by the passion of your Son, they may rejoice in his resurrection, who lives and reigns forever and ever. The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
May the Almighty God bless you, in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Go forth in the peace and love of Christ. The Mass is ended. Alleluia, alleluia.
Thank you.
battlefield for my Lord. I promised him that I would serve him till I die. Yes, I'm on the battlefield for my Lord. Oh, yes, I'm on the battlefield for my Lord. Yes, I'm on the battlefield for my Lord. I promised him that I would serve him till I die. Yes, I'm on the battlefield for my Lord.